You know when you're browsing a website and something moves with your mouse, like a little sparkle or a friendly shape that follows the mouse pointer? It makes websites feel more alive and fun to use, especially in creative projects. And the cool part is that it's actually pretty simple to make. Welcome to Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development one step at a time. Let's start by understanding the concept, and then we'll enhance it further with a focus on accessibility and browser compatibility. We're beginning with a super simple layout that includes a page title and a button. The style sheet already has all the necessary styles for the page title, and the button. This is how it looks in the browser. Nothing fancy, just a plain, straightforward page. To understand how we can track mouse movement, we first need to figure out the mouse position. This can be done easily with just a few lines of JavaScript. So let's create a JS file and include it in the head section of our HTML using a script tag. Inside this file, we'll declare two variables to store the X and Y positions of the mouse pointer. Then, we'll use addEventListener to listen for the mouse move event and update those variables with the pointer's current coordinates. In simple terms, the mouse X and mouse Y variables are initially set to 0. By using addEventListener, we're telling the window object to listen for the mouse move event and update us with the new coordinates of the mouse pointer whenever it moves. Let's add a console log statement to see this in action. Now, when we open the console tab in the browser's developer tools, we'll see the updated coordinates appear with every mouse movement. Instead of just logging these coordinates in the console, we can also display this information on the page itself. Let's add an element in the HTML and attach an ID attribute so we can reference it in our JavaScript. In this case, we're using a paragraph with an empty element inside. Then, in the JS file, we'll use query selector to select the desired element and store its reference in a constant. After that, inside the event listener, we'll replace the console log statement with this updated code snippet. What we're doing here is conditionally updating the inner text property of our HTML element. It first checks if the coordinates variable holds a truthy value, meaning it successfully references an existing HTML element. If it's valid, the inner text of that element is set to a string literal that dynamically displays the current X and Y coordinates of the mouse pointer, using the values stored in the mouse X and mouse Y variables. This effectively renders the real-time mouse position on the web page inside the designated DOM element. If we refresh the page now, we can see everything in action. The coordinates are updating in real time. The top left corner of the page represents the origin, with both X and Y starting at 0. Now comes the next stage of today's effect, the mouse tracking animation. First, we need to add another HTML element that will follow the mouse pointer and bring a touch of creativity to the page. We're also using the aria hidden attribute to hide this element from the accessibility API. It will remove the element from the accessibility tree, improving the experience for users who rely on assistive technologies while still keeping it visible on screen. Next, we'll style it as a fixed positioned element, with top and left set to 0, and its z-index should be set high enough to keep it visible above all other content. The background color uses RGB notation with 25% opacity for a subtle visual effect. We also apply pointer events none to ensure it doesn't interfere with any user interactions and remains purely a decorative element. Finally, we need to apply the transform CSS property to update the element's position on the page. This CSS rule uses custom properties to dynamically set the X and Y coordinates. The first value represents the X axis, the second is for the Y axis, and the third is for the Z axis. In our case, the mouse X CSS variable sets the horizontal position, mouse Y sets the vertical position, and the third value is always 0 since we're only working in a two-dimensional space. If either of these custom properties isn't defined, 0 will be used as the default value. Now let's switch back to JavaScript and make this new element follow the pointer. First, we'll store its reference in a constant. Then, using the set property method on the pointer element, we'll update its mouse X and mouse Y CSS properties. What's happening here is that the setProperty method dynamically assigns the latest values from the JavaScript variables to the corresponding CSS custom properties. We also append px to these values so they're interpreted correctly as pixel units in the CSS. While the element is now following the pointer, this solution still has a few issues. First, the mouse pointer appears fixed to the top left corner of the decorative circle. Ideally, the pointer should sit right at the center of the circle. Second, this approach doesn't perform smoothly in all browsers, particularly Safari, because the coordinates update very rapidly, and some browsers struggle to maintain the pace, leading to a laggy experience. On top of that, it's not optimized for accessibility yet. Let's address these issues one by one. Centering the mouse pointer within the circle is fairly simple. We just need to update the transform CSS property to move the circle -50% on both the X and Y axes. And to animate its movement, we can apply a simple transition with the transition timing function set to ease out. This will create a smooth, natural-looking motion as the circle follows the pointer. To add another layer of creativity, we can enhance the interaction by targeting the hover state of interactive elements. For example, when the mouse hovers over the button, we can increase the width of the circle, make its background transparent, and reveal a border color to highlight the interaction visually. The has pseudo class selector is used to check if the body element contains a button in the hover state. When that condition is true, it triggers a transformation in the circle's size, background, and border to enhance the visual feedback. The ease-out timing function creates a smooth deceleration effect, making it feel like the circle is trying to keep up with the pointer. This adds a touch of realism and makes the interaction feel more dynamic and responsive. The next thing is to make this effect accessible and compatible across browsers. There are a few key steps we can take to improve this. In JavaScript, we start by checking if the user prefers reduced motion and store this preference in a constant. Similarly, we check if the device primarily uses a coarse pointer, usually indicating a touch device, and store that result in another constant. Then we define a Boolean flag shouldRun that controls whether the animation should activate or not. It will be true only if both conditions are false, meaning the user does not prefer reduced motion and the device is not touch-based. This approach is commonly used to conditionally disable animations that could be distracting, unnecessary, or cause performance issues on certain devices, ensuring a smoother and more accessible experience. Now we can wrap our logic inside a conditional block that runs only if the shouldRun variable is true. Also, instead of updating the element's position directly within the mouseMove event handler, we move the setProperty calls into a separate animation loop using requestAnimationFrame. The reason for this is that the mouseMove event can fire dozens of times per second, which may overwhelm the browser's rendering engine. The requestAnimationFrame method tells the browser to run a callback function right before the next repaint. The calls usually match the display's refresh rate, and browsers can pause these calls if needed to improve performance. So in our JavaScript, we're checking if the device is a non-touch device and if the user has not requested reduced motion. Only then do we update the coordinates for the circle to follow the mouse pointer. This logic controls the animation but does not affect the element's visibility. But that's something we can easily handle in CSS using media queries. The prefers reduced motion query hides the circle and coordinates for users who prefer less animation. Similarly, the pointer coarse query hides them on touch devices, so everything feels smooth and intuitive. And that's how simple it is to grab the mouse position and map it using CSS custom properties to create a smooth mouse tracking animation. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your fellow developers, and subscribe to stay updated. Drop your suggestions or feedback in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.